Hello YouTube. Today I'm going to show you how to run to write and run a Java program on Notepad. So let's start by compiling and running the short sample program on Notepad. This sample Java program, and let's start. I'm using the Windows 8, so search for Notepad. This is my notepad, and I'm going to write the Java here, but let's save it on C drive. Let's call it hello world.java. Java, and make sure that you don't save it as a text. Just click down here and all files. Then let's save it on C drive. It depends on where you want to save it, but I'm gonna save it on C drive. And on C drive, I'm going to create a folder called Java and open it and save this program here. And now let's write a simple Java program. And before we begin, let's write, for example, this is a simple Java program. So start with public class, the name of the class hello world, then you add curly braces. Then we type the main method, but before we do that, let's write comments in different way. Comment your program begins with the call to main. We talk about that later. And now let's write the main method. Public static void main string of argument array, and we add curly braces. Alright, then let's print something like hello world. So system.out.println hello world. Yes. And now in Java, a source file is called compilation unit. It is a text file that contains one or more class definitions. Java C requires that a source file use the .java extension. .java extension, and that's what we have used here top. If you look at in Java, all code must reside inside a class. By convention, the name of the public class should match the its name. It means the name of the class here should match the name of the file that we have wrote here. And the Java is a case sensitive. The code we just wrote here will generate the following result if we run it. Just a moment. Now we have to go to cmd, and now we have to change to where we have saved the Java file. My case, I saved it on C, So I have to go there through the command line. So cd then dash dash dot dot, then cd again, then you go back to the C drive, then you change the directory cd java depending on where you saved your Java file. So if you type directory like this, it shows you that on this directory I have this hello world.java. So that now we are going to use a compiler to run the program. To compile the program, we execute the compiler, which is Java C, and the Java C specifying the name of source file on the command line. If you don't have if you type C Java C and you get error, probably just because you haven't set the Java variable on your system. So I recommend you watch my other video that I have done that. So you just watch how to set the Java variable on your system first. So if I want to run this Java file here, you just type Java C space, then you type hello world.java. And now you see if everything goes successful, if you don't get the error, it will return Java like this. The Java C compiler creates a file called hello world.class. So if we go back and check where we have saved the Java here, and we watch, just have a look here, what is going to happen, that the Java C compiler creates a file called hello world.class, and hello world.class contains the bytecode version for the program. So if I'm going to run the program, we use the Java interpreter called Java. We use the compiler called Java, then we pass the name of the class, which is hello world, as a command line argument. So if I type Java here, then I pass the name of the class, which is hello world, then enter. Not find the class, so it means probably the hello world class was not created because we didn't save this file. So we have to save the file, and now let's see, because we have an error, could not find the load main class hello world. So let's try it again. Java C hello world.java, and now we have another error, says that uncloses string. Yes, we have an error here. So go back to the class and we see here we didn't close here. We have to add this, and we save again. We come back again, we run again Java C, and now if we check here, now we see we have just created a class file. So if I delete it again, then I show you, we do it again here, and simultaneously you see, and run apply Okay, now it's created here. So so when the program is run, the following result will happen. So we just have to type now the Java, then we name of the class Hello World, and we get here Hello World. This is the outcome of what we wrote here on our notepad, Hello World. When Java source code is compiled, each individual class is put into its own file name, class name .java. Let's have a close look at the Hello World .java. The first part here, the first part is a comment. The comment is a remark for program. The content of comments are ignored by compiler. The next line is next line of code in a program is public Hello World. This one, public class Hello World. The keyword class declare is here. Declares that a new class is being defined. Hello World is the name of the class. The entire class definition is between the open curly brackets here and closing curly brackets. The next line in the program is single line comment. This one, single line comment. It begin with a forward slash and ends with the end of the line. The next line of a code is showing is a public static void main string argument. Java application begin with discussion by calling the main, this one, the main class, the main method. Java is case sensitive, thus the main is the main is different from this main.